we doing, folks? Well, today we're going to try for a £5 pitcher. So we're just going to cone up the plate first of all, get all the air out of it and get it all lined up. Feel a certain amount of wiggling with this. Because the torque on this type of wheel is a lot different from an electric one, at least in my opinion, it makes it easier to deal with. So, again, don't want too much water. Although this looks centered, it's actually not entirely centered yet. Now we're about centered. Just drive down to establish the floor. Oodles of depth. So. Okay. Knocked the rim out slightly. Just going to establish a nice smooth base. Just call this guy in. Come up very, very slightly. I'm looking for. There's a piece that's tall, but slim. So let's get ready for the first pull. Yeah, a lot of production potters try and get their pieces thrown in three pulls or less. I'm far from a production potter. I think we're looking closer probably to four, maybe five pulls. Again, collaring it to keep it in. And what I've often found with electric wheels is that while it's the speed of the wheel is consistent, it seems to take some of the spontaneity away from the potter. Pull out of this guy and then we can start shaping. And I'll trim the top of this slightly.
top off this. Oops. Just hit the dog with some low-flying clay. I almost tried to leave resetting the rim until the very last. For obvious reasons. The rim's still slightly uneven. Okay. Now we're still a little bit uneven on this rim, so I'm going to take a little bit more off. Then pushing out from the inside, we're going to shape this slightly. And before I start to close up the top, I'm going to put a long neck on this. We can take out the water. There we go. Now, from here, using a number of points of contact, I'm going to push in. Now this neck here is uneven, so I'm going to take a bit of that off. As you can see, it's still a little bit uneven, but by the time we get to the finished article, it's going to be a lot smoother. Of course, the beauty of clay as a material is, of course, the fact that you can use it again. Which is fantastic. Okay, so take off the rest of the slurry from the outside. set the room. Now, of course, it's not going to be a jug unless it's got a pouring spout on it. So, let's rub off the outside. So this allows us to refine the shape a little bit more. And last but not least, taking a little throwing stick down here to the base. This will of course be trimmed and have a foot put on it. So that's going to mean throwing a chuck for it, which I'll show in a follow-up clip in the next few days. Now once you're happy with the form, then you can decide where your pouring spout is going to be. What I usually do is that very simplistic but very effective. The last thing now is to put that in the reclaim. Is of course to wire off the pot. After this, it will get obviously a handle and it will be further trimmed. And there you go, folks, a small jug.